What is up, guys? Johnny here, back with more Call of Duty Mobile. In today's video, I share with you guys my 5 loadouts for ranked multiplayer for the brand new Steel Legion Season 4 ranked season. When you play public games, you can choose your map, you can choose your game mode, but when you go ranked, you don't decide what you're gonna play and you don't know what map it's gonna be. So you gotta be prepared for any map, any situation. That's why we have 5 loadouts. And for many players, 5 loadouts is not enough. Let's get into it, guys. And before we start, a quick word from today's sponsor. This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Raid Shadow Legends is a dark fantasy RPG, and it's available on mobile and on PC. You can play your same account on PC when you get home. And I don't know if you guys got lots of free time right now and you want to try new games, might as well download that one. Link in the description. It's totally free. And you guys know how much I love RPGs. And this one's pretty much the best, guys. There's tons of things to do, tons of game modes. But basically what you do, guys, is you collect champions and you bring them into the battle and you collect rewards at the end, including silver and artifacts. And then you can make your champions even stronger. Now, this game's got hundreds of champions to collect, guys. And it's probably what I like the most about Raid Shadow Legends is the artwork. If you're tired of childish, cartoonish games, well, this one's for you because the characters really awesome, for real. The artwork, you did a great job on that one. Now, the daily login rewards program for new players have doubled from 90 days to 180 days. So each day you can log in and claim your free rewards up until the end, where you can get a brand new legendary barbarian champion, Sile of the Drakes. Now, guys, go to the link in the description if you want to check out this game for free. You'll get 100,000 silver, some free energy and gems, and a free champion. Look at this cool champion you'll get for free, guys. You'll get a free executioner champion just by downloading the game. But guys, do it now because the link is only available for the next 30 days. Now, once you're in the game, you can claim your free rewards in the top right corner right there. So guys, look for me in the game, JHC Gaming. Once again, link in the description. And thanks, Raid Shadow Legends, for sponsoring this video. Okay, now let's get into the loadouts. It is still early in the season. I'm still experimenting, but for now, that's what I'm using. It's been working pretty good lately. Now, this is my number one loadout. It's mostly for team deathmatch, and I changed my playstyle a little bit last season. I start using SMGs and rushing classes for team deathmatch. So I like the extra mobility from the SMGs. Last season, I was using the AKS or the RUS-79U. This season, I changed a few times, but I'm using the GKS right now. It's been a few days and I'm impressed. I like it more than I thought I would. Again, it's an SMG, so good mobility, but this one's not the best at very close range, but medium range, like, it's got low recoil. It's pretty accurate. It's a pretty decent weapon. The time to kill, I thought it was a bit slow at the start. I'm getting used to it and maybe I'll change my mind later. But for now, guys, it's what I've been using for a few days. I love this weapon. Now, I always use the SMRS on Team Deathmatch. I like to take out the score streaks, guys. When I see enemy UAV, counter UAVs and stuff, it's also good. Some guys use it for killing, but I use it mostly for destroying score streaks. Now, again, it's a rushing loadout, so I use Hardwire, so I don't have to worry about the trip mines, and I use Lightweight for extra speed. Now, about the Hardwire versus toughness, what I learned from the pros last season, I had a couple interviews with some very good players. They say they use toughness if their weapon has high recoil, and they use Hardwire if their weapon has low recoil. So this weapon's pretty accurate, guys, and that's why I thought Hardwire was perfect for that. So you can rush, not have to look for trip mines everywhere. Now, for the third perk, guys, I very often use Dead Silence in most of my loadouts. It does make a difference, guys. If you watch the streams, when someone's not using Dead Silence, you hear them and you're gonna get the advantage because of that. It gives you an edge when you use it, so I suggest you guys use Dead Silence. Now, trophy system, I don't use that much. I kind of want to go maybe concussion or flashbang and start using it a little bit more. Frag grenade on all my loadouts, pretty much. I love frag grenades. And for the operator skill, I use War Machine, but it's because I had a challenge killing 10 enemies with RPGs. But I really like Dead Machine also, so I kind of alternate. Some days I will use Dead Machine, some days I will use War Machine. So it's up to you guys, always personal preference. And then on the Tactical Unicorn, well, you don't need the Legendary, by the way. It's just a GKS, same stats, same damage. It's been confirmed, and Hawksness made a video about it. GKS is a good SMG. I use the extended mag, quick draw to aim down sight faster, and foregrip. A lot of guys confirmed on my comments they also like the foregrip. Some guys say you don't need foregrip because it's pretty accurate. So if you don't like foregrip, you can go with something else like FMJ or something. But for now, I'm using this. It's working really good, guys. Now, my loadout number two is my objective mode loadout. I use that mostly for domination and hardpoint. So last season, I was using Defender Shield for domination. It's really, really good for capturing B or whatever. It really helps. But we have Hive now, and Hive is maybe more versatile, but the downside is it's very strong, but if you die, it all goes away, so it's kind of a waste. But when you use it, it can really shut down the map, especially in hardpoint. You know where your enemies are coming from. You can shoot left and right and middle, and it's gonna slow them down quite a bit. It's gonna buy you some precious time. So very good for hardpoint, kind of good for domination also. But again, if you die, you gotta play smarter when you use it and try to stay alive to get the most value. Now, once again, I use Dead Silence. You don't have to, because maybe sometimes there's more chaos in objective games, so you could go hardline instead, but I still use Dead Silence, and I use Flak Jacket. Like, this is not a rushing loadout. I like to survive a little bit more. When you capture or defend objectives, you're more likely going to receive explosion damage, so it will save your life quite a few times wearing that Flak Jacket. Again, it's personal preference. Your movement's gonna suffer a little bit. Some guys say lightweight is better for covering the distance faster, get back to the objective when you need to. So yeah, personal preference. This is my loadout for domination and hardpoint. Once again, SMRS, I really like that. It is versatile. And then I use AK-117. Some guys say in objective you need short range weapon, but it's all about your playstyle, guys. And I find out I'm myself more often going to get into longer range gunfights. I like to cut down players coming from the objectives when we had control. So AK-117 is such a great weapon, guys. It is versatile. It's an AR. It's really good at long range, medium range. High fire rate, very decent damage. I love the AK-117. And this is what I'm using right now. And so far, so good. Now, my next loadout is a classic. I've been using the same for a few seasons for Search and Destroy on offense. Search and Destroy is a tactical game mode. There's more strategy. So I'm using the PDW. I love SMGs. I love mobility. Lightweight again. Hardwire again. You don't want to die to a trip mine in Search and Destroy, because then you have to wait for the respawn. And once again, Dead Silence. It is a must. I know some guys use Alert. I think it's a mistake. Depends on your playstyle once again, but Dead Silence is the way to go, in my opinion. Now, I don't use the SMRS. You're not likely going to see score streaks, and I'd rather switch weapon quickly in the middle of a fight if you're running out of ammo or whatever. Now, I use a silencer on my PDW in Search and Destroy, trying to stay, like, not reveal my position to the enemy team. The operator doesn't matter because you're never gonna use it. And I'm using smoke grenades in Search and Destroy. It can be used to trick your opponents. Let's say you're the last dude alive, you can throw a smoke on B and then go for A. And also, it's good for crossing lanes when you know you're gonna get sniped, so you can cross on the smoke and not getting sniped. So it's actually pretty useful. And once again, PDW is one of the good short range SMGs. Still some guys like MSMC, but I've been using PDW for a while. It's more versatile in my opinion. It's not as good as super close range, but at least you get more options. So I love the PDW, guys. And yeah, I made a whole video quite a few times about that loadout. It's one of my favorite loadouts, guys. Once again, Search and Destroy on the attack. Now, sniper loadout, you need one, guys. You should have at least one sniper loadout. But I really love to use snipers in Search and Destroy on defense. And once again, it's a matter of playstyle. Perk number one, most sniper players will use Agile here because you aim down sight faster, so it's better for quick scoping. But I don't use my sniper for running around and quick scoping. So I use lightweight, because on defense, on search, I want to get to my spot faster. And then I'm going to hard scope most of the time, trying to cover some lanes. So it's not a big deal here. I still use dead silence, and I use toughness here. Now, once again, it's personal preference, guys. If you like to move around and quick scope, use agile instead, and maybe use the locust. It's a better sniper for moving around, better mobility, faster aim down sight, but maybe more hit markers. Now, my last loadout is a bit more versatile. It used to be my S36 loadout, but after the nerf, I end up not really using my S36. So I went back with a second AK-117 loadout, but this time it's the dead machine instead of the hive. Also, I will not be using the dead silence on that one. I will be using hardline. So it's better for small maps, team deathmatch, again, because there's more chaos. You don't care if your enemies hear your footsteps. You're gonna get your score streaks faster. You're gonna get a better chance to win. And again, dead machine versus hive probably is better for team deathmatch. So again, I use the flight jacket because I don't really think the mobility is needed on smaller maps. So yeah, it was my S36 loadout last season. I just changed to AK-117, and I'll see if I really need to change for another fifth loadout, but the utility is the same. Again, hardline, faster score streaks, a weapon that I think is pretty good at pretty much any range, and that machine for the operator skill. That's what I have so far. I know it's still early in the season. I might change my loadouts later. If you guys have some great, great ideas, post in the comments below. I'm always open to try some new loadouts if I think it's great. And I will give you guys some feedback later. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you're gonna try these loadouts and let me know how it works for you. Now, if you enjoyed these videos, make sure you subscribe to the channel for daily COD Mobile videos. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.